I've already built a simple expense application in Visual Builder. Now I want to add business logic and SaaS services to the application. I go back into the development environment and switch the view to look at the designer for the business object. I can see the expense and types objects, and I can modify them. For example, I'll add some business logic to the expense report to check if an expense item is too costly. This will happen every time I insert a record. If I edit the new trigger, I can define a specific flow. I start with a condition. In the condition, I check whether the cost is excessive. I give it a name. I define the condition. I'm using a basic condition here to check if the cost is greater than a specific amount. I choose $100 as the limit. I want to define an action if this is the case. I set up a name for the action and add the logic. I can choose from a list of options. If the item's too costly, the approval field will be set to true. I go back to the page designer and run the application again. This time, I create a new expense, and I make it expensive. This is a lunch with a value greater than $100. I choose a type. Notice I'm not checking the approval field. I click Save and Close. In the table that's displayed, the business logic has been invoked. The approval field's been automatically set to true. This is the implementation of business logic in the application. The user interface can scale to show different device sizes. I can tune the look and feel of the application even further. For example, I can choose the table and say that on a phone, in portrait mode, instead of a table, I want to show a list. I can even eliminate some of the fields from being shown on a smaller device. Here I have a short list with a few fields. If I switch to a bigger device, I can see the full list of fields in the table. I go back into the page designer. Again, using the live preview, I go to the Edit Expense page. I'm adding a field that gets data from an external service. In the data dictionary, I look at the service catalog. The service catalog includes a list of services that were pre-populated from an Oracle SaaS application and other services. In this case, I select a service from the Oracle Human Capital Management System. This is related to locations. I choose the location object. I can choose which field I want to show. I can choose the authentication type that I want the application to use. I just added another source of data to the application. I can drag a new field into this page and hook the field up to the new object and a specific field within it. This creates a new field in the expense report. I name the field Location. I go back to the home page and run the application. Again, I edit one of the records. Now I can choose a location with values coming directly from an Oracle SaaS application. That's how easy it is to extend the application to use Oracle SaaS information. Once the application's ready to get tested, I use this stage to create an instance of the application that users can test. Once the tests have passed, I can publish the application to create a real live instance of the application that people can use. That's the development experience with Oracle Visual Builder Cloud Service. For more information, visit us online at cloud.oracle.com/visualbuilder.